natürlich gerne meine Mitspieler irgendwo einsetze, auch irgendwo gerne gut aussehen lasse. Wenn man jetzt abends irgendwo zusammensitzt, bin ich nicht so gerne der Kellner, dann nehme ich lieber die Getränke entgegen.
Making others shine. That corresponds perfectly to Toni Kroos. The midfielder has an unequaled level of modesty. This has allowed him to accomplish amazing things and be incredibly consistent. But it's in particular thanks to an impressive work ethic. The German believed in his dream right until the end. So, if you want to achieve something, follow Toni Kroos's example, also known as the Invisible Maestro. Hey, oh my goalers, your feedback on our format, Life Goal, is very important to us. If you enjoy this show, please subscribe. But most importantly, we need your help at the end of this episode. We'll let you know at the end of this Life Goal on Toni Kroos. But let's get back to Toni. Toni Kroos was born on January 4th, 1990 in Greifswald. This city of 50,000 inhabitants is found in the northeast of Germany, mere yards from the Baltic Sea. At the time, the country was in the middle of a reunification process. Toni grew up in a region that was formerly part of East Germany. Huge wars and tension had left a number of scars there. When the United States and the USSR occupied German territory, two worlds faced off against each other. On the west side, significant industrialization with a flourishing economy. On the other, in the east, almost nothing. And it's in this Germany that the Kroos family was settled. They weren't rolling in money, but led a comfortable life. Toni and his younger brother Felix received an education based on simple principles: humility, collaboration, love, and sharing. It's with these values that the older brother started football. At 7 years old, Toni joined the local club and played under his father's command. For Roland Kroos, sport had an important role to play in his son's education, and that's also how their mother Birgit saw things. A former badminton player, she knew the importance of competition. His father was a former wrestler who put hard work above everything. He taught his protégés that individuality is only useful when it's used in the service of the team. At the same time, he passed on something very important to his kids: work ethic. He taught them that without hard work, it's impossible to achieve anything. Through this, Roland taught them to have confidence in themselves and their skills, and that you should never give up even if you fail, and that you should always get back up after a fall. As for Toni, he stood out for his style of play. Off the pitch, he was quite a shy kid who was liked by his schoolmates. But on the pitch, the young man was different, but without really changing. He stood out without making a fuss. Physically, he wasn't the most imposing, but his intelligence and his read of the game helped him anticipate better than anyone else. Toni's biggest strength is the excellence of his technique, which he proves when he plays. He's always got his head up. This helps him have a perfect vision of the game. Quickly, his skills caught the attention and interest of the big clubs. When he was 12, the kid followed his father to Hansa Rostock. There, Toni confirmed his status and got even better. A few years later, his club agreed to part ways with him for a significant sum of money. The only club that was able to buy him was none other than Bayern Munich. Thanks to the establishment of two Germanies, the Bavarian club improved faster than all the rest. In East Germany, football and money were two things that didn't go together. There wasn't enough money to develop. They lacked industry and sponsors in these regions. The clubs didn't have the same economic means as the West and didn't offer the same prospects. That's why young Toni Kroos decided to leave aged 16. Financial reasons played a major role in his decision, because in Bayern, this talented midfielder had the resources to perfectly develop. But in particular, he was able to surround himself with skilled people. Thanks to all these ingredients, Toni Kroos could follow the recipe to glory. When he arrived in Bavaria, Toni Kroos was already expected to be one of the biggest talents in German football. He made his debut with Bayern and quickly stood out for his ease with the ball. Toni may have just been a teen, but he was already behaving like a top professional. The boy was gifted with impressive maturity and significant self-confidence. Clearly, he wasn't afraid of anything. But in January 2009, things started to get complicated. Bayern's directors sent him on loan to Leverkusen. For the player, it was the chance for him to prove his worth. Toni Kroos didn't stop after this bit of bad luck. He knew he had the ability to shine alongside the greats. He proved his incredible determination and fighting spirit. The Greifswald native didn't give in. He worked very hard and doubled his efforts. He made a name for himself after a season and a half in North Rhine-Westphalia. Toni Kroos was now a real player capable of managing pressure. Better still, he was largely capable of managing a team like Bayern's midfield. The German might not have been the Bavarian team's superstar, but he was indispensable. The great Jupp Heynckes took him under his wing and turned him into a real maestro. Kroos quickly established himself as one of the best players in his position. When he was on the pitch, he didn't make a lot of noise and seemed completely normal. But it was in his absence that you realized how important he was. In the middle of the 2010s, he was part of one of the best teams on the planet. Bayern Munich crushed everything in their path and won dozens of trophies. In 2013, Toni even won the first Champions League of his career. He spent a season working under Pep Guardiola before leaving Bavaria in the summer of 2014. 2014 happened to be Toni Kroos's most successful year. In July, the German's status changed forever. While he'd been incredible for a long time on the pitch, he really made his way into the spotlight. Firstly, he played an extraordinary World Cup with Die Mannschaft. In the semifinals, he was involved in Brazil's humiliation. Goals, important passes, Toni Kroos was everywhere. And a few days after his team was crowned, he signed for the club, Real Madrid. The Spanish club bought the maestro for $30 million, a figure that didn't seem proportional to the player's talent. But the German didn't need a lot of money to show how good he was. At Real, he formed an elite trio with Luka Modric and Casemiro. Together, they dominated Europe and won three Champions League titles. Toni Kroos was omnipresent in this success and always responded to his team's needs. However, he often played the role of the invisible hero, because while he shined on the pitch, he was very discreet off it. The Spanish media and fans even wondered what he did in his free time. The player was making the most of his family. He spent a huge part of his time working, because Toni was 300% committed in order to be so consistent. Kroos is as good as he is humble, to the extent he always wears the same boots. This model. And he even washes them himself. I know people might think I'm crazy, but it's important for me to see white shoes when I look down. It's, I don't know if it's some kind of psychological problem I have, but my shoes have to be white when I'm playing. This behavior perfectly sums up the kind of man he is. A simple man who worked hard to have so much success. Because today, Toni Kroos is one of the best players on the planet in his position. To get to this point, he's had to battle non-stop. The German had to prove that he had the guts to succeed in the football world. But thanks to a lot of humility, self-belief, and determination, it paid off. And most importantly, he's never stopped improving to stay at the top. So, set yourself a goal and never give up. And when you achieve it, keep working to perfect your skills. Because the hardest thing isn't reaching the top, but staying there. Thanks for watching this video. As we told you at the start of this episode, we need your help. Your opinion is so important for us. That's why we want to know what player should we talk about in an upcoming episode of Life Goal. For this, you have the choice between Franck Ribéry and Raheem Sterling. Let us know who you want us to talk about in the comments. The player with the most votes will star in the next episode of Life Goal. The power is in your hands. Don't get